मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अलाइड एंगल्स, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सेशन फॉर क्लास प्लस वन एज ए पार्ट ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री एज वेल एज फॉर आई टी जेई एनडीए एंड एमसीए एग्जामिनेशन. लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द अलाइड एंगल. राइट, बिफोर गोइंग टू द डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ इट, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस टर्म अलाइड एंगल. एन एंगल इज सेड टू बी अलाइड इफ सम और डिफरेंस इज इक्वल टू जीरो और मल्टीपल ऑफ पाई बाय टू. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, लेट अस से वन एंगल इज एक्स, तो अलाइड एंगल ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस एक्स. इफ आई एड बोथ, सम इज इक्वल टू जीरो, पाई बाय टू माइनस एक्स. व्हेन आई एड बोथ, तो सम इज इक्वल टू पाई बाय टू. और यू मे से पाई माइनस एक्स, इफ आई एड बोथ, सम इज इक्वल टू पाई. राइट, देयर सम और देयर डिफरेंस, इफ दैट इज आइदर जीरो और मल्टीपल ऑफ पाई बाय टू, तो दोज एंगल्स आर सेड टू बी अलाइड एंगल्स. राइट, अब यहां हमारे लिए क्या इंपॉर्टेंट है, वट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस. द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट फॉर अस इज वट इज द यूज ऑफ दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. राइट, हाउ टू अप्लाई दिस इन सॉल्विंग डिफरेंट वराइटीज ऑफ प्रॉब्लम. द मेन एम ऑफ दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज because since we know that our table of trigonometry from 0 to 90 degree, 30 degree, 60 degree, 45 degree, sometimes our angles are more than 90. So in that case, how to find those angles? So there, that concept of allied angle helps us. Like for example, we have to find the value of sine of 120 degree, right? Now with the concept of the allied angle, we can easily answer it. So that we will understand in this session, right? As well as we solve number of problems on this concept of allied angle. We divide our whole sequence in two parts. First one is either we can associate our angle as pi plus theta, pi minus theta, 2 pi plus theta, or 2 pi minus theta, right? Or it would be pi by 2 plus theta, pi by 2 minus theta, 3 pi by 2 plus theta, or 3 pi by 2 minus theta, right? What we can say, either we take it as pi plus theta, pi minus theta, 2 pi plus theta, 2 pi minus theta, or the same can be taken as pi by 2 minus theta, pi by 2 plus theta, 3 pi by 2 plus theta, or 3 pi by 2 minus theta. Let us take the first case. If you are associating your angle in this shape with pi or 2 pi, or you may say 180 plus theta, 180 minus theta, 360 plus theta, or 360 minus theta. Okay. So in that case, our first rule is trigonometrical ratio will remain same. Trigonometrical ratio will remain same. Right? Means if we have sine 180 plus theta, it would be sine theta. If we have cos 180 minus theta, it will be cos theta. First thing, trigonometrical ratio will be same. Second thing, sine plus or minus will be according to original quadrant, will be according to original angle. Whatever angle we are finding out, it should be according to that, right? First we try to solve some question on this, after that we will move further. Let us take an example. Suppose I have to find sine of 180 plus theta. I have to comment on this. Sine of 180 plus theta. Now observe here. Sine 180 plus theta, since we are associating with 180, it means this is equal to sine theta, first thing. Why? Since we know if we are associating our angle with 180 plus theta, 180 minus theta, 360 plus theta, or 360 minus theta, in that case, trigonometrical ratio will remain the same, right? Second thing, plus minus will be according to the original angle. Now, while sine of 180 plus theta, which quadrant it is? It lies in third quadrant, okay? Sine in third quadrant will always be negative. Hence, my answer should be minus sine theta, right? Similarly, if I write tangent of 360 minus theta, we have to answer it, okay? Now, tangent of 360 minus theta, since we are associating with 360, it means write it as tangent theta, okay? Now, in which quadrant it lies? 360 minus theta is fourth quadrant, okay? तो टेंजेंट इन फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट इज ऑलवेज नेगेटिव माइनस टेंजेंट थीटा, ओके। तो टेंजेंट ऑफ 360 माइनस थीटा इज टेकन एज माइनस टेंजेंट थीटा, राइट। नाउ इफ यू हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन 120 डिग्री, तो व्हाट यू कैन से, लेट अस से साइन 120 डिग्री, तो हियर वी हैव अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ 180 प्लस माइनस थीटा, तो मेक इट एज साइन ऑफ 180 माइनस 60, दैट यू मे से। नाउ साइन 180 माइनस 60 इज टेकन एज साइन 60, एंड आउटसाइड प्लस माइनस विल बी अकॉर्डिंग टू ओरिजिनल एंगल। तो साइन 120 लाइज इन सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट, इन सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट वी नो साइन इज ऑलवेज पॉजिटिव, इट मीन्स दिस इज पॉजिटिव, तो आंसर इज साइन 160, साइन 60, नाउ यू नो साइन 60 इज रूट 3 बाय 2, तो आंसर टू साइन 120 डिग्री इज रूट 3 बाय 2, ओके। तो दिस इज अवर फर्स्ट पॉइंट। नाउ लेट अस टेक द सेकंड पॉइंट, व्हेन वी आर एसोसिएटिंग अवर एंगल विद पाई बाय 2 प्लस थीटा, पाई बाय 2 माइनस थीटा, 3 पाई बाय 2 प्लस थीटा, 3 पाई बाय 2 माइनस थीटा, और यू मे से दिस इज 90 प्लस थीटा, 90 माइनस थीटा, 270 प्लस थीटा और 270 माइनस थीटा, ओके। नाउ इन दैट केस व्हाट वी कैन डू, फर्स्ट पॉइंट दैट वी हैव टू कंसीडर, ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिकल रेशियो विल चेंज, राइट। हाउ दे विल चेंज, साइन विल बिकम कोसाइन एंड कोस विल बिकम साइन, ओके। सिमिलर वे टेंजेंट बिकम्स कोटेंजेंट एंड कोटेंजेंट बिकम्स टेंजेंट, सीकेंट बिकम कोसिकेंट एंड कोसिकेंट बिकम्स सीकेंट, राइट। तो हाउ इट विल बी चेंज्ड, साइन विल बिकम कोस एंड कोस विल बिकम साइन, टेंजेंट इज कन्वर्टेड इंटू कोटेंजेंट एंड कोटेंजेंट इंटू टेंजेंट and secant into cosecant and cosecant into secant. That's the first thing. Second thing that we have to consider here, it will be the same. Plus minus sign will be according to original angle. Will be according to original angle. Whatever your original angle is there, that will be according to that. Okay? For example, if I consider here, so what is given to me, according to this, suppose I have to find out plus minus according to original quadrant. Suppose I write sine of 90 plus theta. What is given to me? Sine of 90 plus theta. I know that 90 plus theta, it means sine will be converted into cosine. So that will be cos theta. Now 90 plus theta is second quadrant, and we know that sine in second quadrant will always be positive. So it should be plus cos theta. Now this is very important for us. Sometimes we commit mistake here. If it is cos theta, so our angle plus minus should be according to this, not according to this, right? Suppose if I write sine of 270 plus theta. Okay, now it should be cos theta, no problem. 270 plus theta, which quadrant it is? It is in fourth quadrant, and we know that in fourth quadrant sine will be negative. So it is taken as minus cos theta, okay? Suppose I write tangent of 270 minus theta. Now we know that tangent of 270, it means tangent 270, that will be cotangent theta, first thing. Now angle 270 minus theta is in third quadrant. We know that tangent in third quadrant is always positive. It should be plus cot theta, right? So similar way, any angle that you have to find. For example, if I write, we have to find tangent of 120 degree. So now here I associate with 90 plus theta, I may take it as tangent of 90 plus 30, right? Now this is taken as minus cotangent 30. This is very important for you. Why? Tangent 90 plus theta is equal to cotangent theta. Since it lies in the second quadrant, it will be negative. So minus cotangent theta, the cot theta is, that should be, tan 30 is 1 by root 3, cot 30 is root 3. The answer should be minus root 3, it becomes your answer, right? So this is very important thing to understand. This point must be clear in your mind. Now number of questions we have on this topic, which are primarily based on the concept of allied angles, where you have to simply find the values and according to the quadrant you have to answer your problems. Let us start with solving some questions so that you will get an exact idea about the topic allied angles. Suppose we have to find out cos of 1050 degree. First question is, find out cos of 1050 degree, right? Now we know that if our angle exceeds 360 degree, so try to first convert between 0 to 360. So we know that 360 can be subtracted twice, since 360 into 2 is 720. So we can say cos of 1050 minus 720, or this is equal to cos of 330 degree. First thing, okay, now I may take it as cos of 360 minus 30. It would be cos 30, and sine will be positive. Why? Since it is in fourth quadrant, and we know that cosine in fourth quadrant will always be positive. It should be plus cos 30. Now what is the value of cos 30? Cos 30 is root 3/2. So answer to my question is cosine of 1050 is always equal to root 3/2. Okay, let us take one more question. Tangent of 1575 degree. Tangent of minus 1575 degree, right? We have to find the value. Now in this question, what I can say, since you know tangent of minus theta is always equal to minus tangent theta, that I told you in my earlier class, okay? So this is taken as minus tangent of 1575 degree. Next thing, we know that it is exceeding a 360 degree. So we try to make it between 0 to 360. So just try to take the multiple of 360, that will cancel it. That I can say 360 into 4. 1440. It means I may write it as minus tangent of 1575 minus 1440. Okay? Now you may say minus tangent of, this is equal to 135 degree. That is minus tangent of 135 degree. Now your question is very simple. Make it as minus tangent of 180 minus 45. First thing, that would be minus tangent of 45. Since it is in second quadrant, so one more minus would be there. So that minus make it positive. This is tangent of 45, which is equal to 1. Right? So we can say that value of tangent of minus 1575 will be equal to 1. That becomes your answer. Okay. Let us solve a few more questions here. My next question is, we have to find the value of tangent of 315 degree, tangent of 315 degree into cotangent of minus 405 degree plus cotangent of 495 degree, cotangent of 495 degree into tangent of minus 585, into tangent of minus 585, right? That is given to us. We have to find its value. So what we can start with this question, tangent of 315, you may write it as tangent of 360 minus 45. First step, cotangent of minus 405, minus could be taken outside, since we know that in cos minus theta and secant minus theta, that is equal to cos theta and secant theta. Rest in sine, cosecant, tangent, cotangent, minus will come outside. Now we are being left with cot 405 degree, which is taken as cotangent of 360 plus 45, first thing. Similarly, plus cotangent of 360 plus 135, and here take minus outside, and this would be taken as tangent of 360 plus 225 degree, that we can say. Now tangent of 360 minus 45, fourth quadrant, so this is minus tangent of 45, this is minus 1, and cotangent of 360 plus 45, that is cotangent of 45, plus cotangent of 360 plus 135, so it should be cot 135, so take it as minus cotangent of 135, and here you may say tangent of 225. Okay, in the next step, this is 1 and this is 1, minus minus plus, this would be 1. Now what I can say, minus cotangent of 180 minus 45 into my tangent of 180 plus 45, tangent of 180 plus 45. Now this is taken as 1 minus cot 180 minus 45, that is equal to second quadrant, it will be positive, so we may take it as plus cot of 45. Since second quadrant cotangent will be negative, so minus minus makes it positive. Similarly here, tangent of 180 plus 45, that is equal to tangent 45, which is 1. So 1 plus 1, we can say 2 is our answer. So I can say that answer to my question is said to be 2. Right? Let us take some more questions. Next question we have is, we have been given as 2 sine square 3 pi by 4. 2 sine square 3 pi by 4 plus 2 cos square pi by 4 plus 2 cos square pi by 4 plus 2 secant square pi by 3. 2 secant square pi by 3, we have to find its value. Okay. Now when we observe this question, so what we can say, you may simply say that 2. Here you may say sine square of pi minus pi by 4. Cos pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. So that is 2 into 1 by root 2 square 1 by 2 plus secant pi by 3. You know that cos pi by 3 is 1 by 2. So secant will be 2. So it is 2 into square of 2, that is 4. Right? Now solve it. 2 into sine pi by 4 1 by root 2, that is 1 by 2 plus 2 into 1 by 2 plus 8. 1 plus 1 plus 8, 8 plus 2 is 10, right? So what we can say, answer to my question is said to be 10. So finally our answer is equal to 10. Okay, let us take a few more questions. My idea is very simple. Since concept is easy, so once you understand the concept, after that few questions will enable you to understand it better, so that in your examination you may easily solve it. Next question is, cosecant of 90 plus A, cosecant of 90 plus A plus x cos A into cotangent of 90 plus A equal to sine 90 plus A, sine of 90 plus A, we have to solve it and find x. Our question is, find x, right? Now what you can say, cosecant of 90 plus A, second quadrant cosecant will be positive, that is equal to secant A, plus x cos A into cotangent of 90 plus A. Cotangent in second quadrant would be negative, cot 90 plus A would be tangent, so that is minus tangent A, equal to sine 90 plus A. Second quadrant, that is said to be cosine of A, since in second quadrant that will be sine will be positive, right? Now that value we have got. So what I can say, I may take this value there, or that would be sine A by cos A. So what I can say, this is 1 by cos A minus cos A here, 1 by cos A minus cos A here, right? And this value goes there, that is x cos A into sine A divided by cosine of A. ठीक है? I hope this is clear. Now this is cancelled out. That would be 1 minus cos square A divided by cos A equal to x sine A. Right? Now you know 1 minus cos square theta is sine square theta. So you will write it as sine square A divided by cos A equal to x sine A. Sine A will be cancelled out. So x is equal to sine A divided by cos A. So you may set that is equal to tangent of A, right? So x is equal to tangent A, that becomes your answer, right? So we have to simply find the value of the x. So finally we can say that value of the x will be equal to tangent A, right? Let us take one more question here. Question number 6. It is given that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. And what we have to prove? We have to prove that cos A plus cos B, cos A plus cos B plus cos C plus cos D equal to 0. Right? This result we have to prove. It is given that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, and we have to prove that cos A plus cos B plus cos C plus cos D equal to 0. Now we know that in any cyclic quadrilateral, sum of the opposite angle is always equal to 180 degree. This is A, B, C and D. So one thing I can say, A plus C equal to B plus D, the sum is equal to 180 degree, right? So we know that in any cyclic quadrilateral, sum of the opposite angles is always equal to 180 degree. Now just replace here. So what I can say, A would be taken as 180 minus C. We have taken cos of 180 minus C. And B is taken as 180 minus D. So I may write it as cos of 180 minus D plus cos C plus cos of D. Right? Now, cos of 180 minus C, second quadrant, cos will be negative. So that is considered as minus cos C. Here it is minus cos D plus cos C and plus cos D. That is cancelled out. This is equal to 0. Hence proved. So hence we can say that according to the given result, we can simply say that will always be equal to 0. Okay? So if ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, so in that case that we can say that this result will always be equal to 0. Let us take a few more questions. Next we have question number 7 here. This simply states that we have to find the value of secant of 3 pi by 2 minus theta into secant of theta minus secant of theta minus 5 pi by 2, right, plus tangent of 5 by plus tangent of 5 pi by 2 plus theta, right, into tangent of theta minus 3 pi by 2, into tangent of theta minus 3 pi by 2. This we have to find the value of this, right? Now what I can say, secant of 270 minus theta, third quadrant, it will be negative, that is cosecant minus cosecant theta. I hope this is clear, since it is 270 degree. Okay, so secant of 270 minus theta, third quadrant, so we can say this is minus cosecant theta. Here if I take minus outside, so that would be same as secant of, that is you may simply take it as 5 pi by 2 minus theta, since cos minus theta or secant minus theta is the same. Here you may say if I subtract 2 pi out of this, because a 360 can be subtracted, 2 pi can be subtracted. So when I subtract 2 pi, that is equal to tangent of pi by 2 plus theta. Here also if I take minus outside, so that would be minus of tangent of 3 pi by 2 minus theta. That value we have. Now try to solve. So this is equal to minus cosecant theta, right? 2 pi subtract from here, 5 pi by 2 minus 2 pi, that is pi by 2. So make it as secant of pi by 2 minus theta. Here it is tangent pi by 2 plus theta is minus cot theta, right? And here also tangent of 270 minus theta is equal to cot theta. So I may say that is minus cot theta. Now that is equal to minus cot theta, sorry, they are in multiplication. If they are in multiplication, so that would be negative and negative, so that would be plus positive, right? Now minus cosecant theta, secant of pi by minus 2 theta is cosecant theta plus cot square theta. Okay, so minus cosecant square theta plus cot square theta. Okay, now we know that cot square theta, cot square theta minus cosecant square theta is always equal to minus 1. That's our standard identity. Hence, I can say that the value of this question is equal to minus 1. I hope you understood the concept now. So this is the concept of the allied angles, a very important session for making your base, as well as number of questions can be made on this. That's why I tried to solve some of the questions here on the board, so that students who are studying it for the first time or students who are revising it, so with the help of this session, they are able to revise the concept, and also they are in a position to understand what type of questions can be asked in your examination. For more videos, you may log in to our website www.dineshmiglani.com or you may subscribe our YouTube channel Dinesh Miglani Tutorials. Thank you very much.